what's different about these schools?
It's the same difference at all of North Penn 17 schools.
If you look deep inside, each of these classrooms have become even more exciting than ever.
I see mine on the desk.
I love the sound effect of PowerPoint.
Oh, wow, look at that picture.
Since the North Penn Board of School Directors implemented this three-year, three-phase technology plan, thousands of feet of cable have been snaked through the walls in all of North Penn's 17 schools. 1,200 computers have been placed directly in the hands of our 13,000 students.
We're doing a PowerPoint for noise pollution, and
In our 13 elementary schools, each classroom in grades 4 through 6 now have 4 computers, a printer, and a large screen monitor.
Technology here at Englewood seems to be moving along. We enjoy working on the computers. The kids are really learning a lot. Sometimes they can tell me how to do different things.
Grades kindergarten through first have one computer right now, but by the end of phase 3, they will have a total of 4 per classroom.
With the addition of the new compact and also the TV, it allows me to use the remote keyboard to work throughout the classroom or pass the keyboard around to my students and let them type in.
North Penn's technology team has installed computers and labs at each of North Penn's 3 middle schools. At the high school, math, science, social studies, and English classrooms all have a computer, printer, VCR, laser disc player, and a large screen monitor.
The North Penn High School IMC has been fully updated with new computers, and the Technology Education Lab has been equipped with 15 new, powerful graphic workstations.
Most of the computers at the secondary level have been networked to receive internet access. All elementary schools will be networked by the end of the 1999-2000 school year.
It makes it much easier for them to get right on the computers. We had a computer lab where we were only allowed to go down once a week, and it was a scheduled time period, and then the printers wouldn't work and so forth. This makes it much more flexible for the students. If we're doing any research, they can hop right on the computer, and they have no problem getting on that computer and finding information for their research.
They love it. In fact, they're coming in knowing computers, so it ties in very nicely with the program, language arts especially. And
you're down there.
Throughout this adoption, one of the things that we've really stressed is that technology should not replace good teaching and the basic skills. But we have to keep in mind that these basic skills in today's society are changing, so technology becomes a great tool to make sure that we provide those skills that students will need as they leave North Penn for further education or the work world.
Well, this is D9, the Staff Development Center for the North Penn School District, and we started in the beginning of February here, and we have classes for our teachers. Every day, Monday through Thursday, teachers come in from all over the district and they receive their technology staff development here.
Yeah, I have no check. I just have to...
The internet is changing the way people gather information.
What are you looking for?
North Penn is harnessing that power to enrich the research materials available to each of our students.
The internet has allowed so many new opportunities for the kids in the classroom. They now can see things they've never been able to see before, get information that they couldn't get, and communicate with people all over the world that they wouldn't normally have the chance to do.
We have a different site that we go into every day. These are archaeologists out in the southwest studying the Anasazi Indians.
History.
There are questions that the scientists pose to them, and then they answer the question, and then we see answers from other schools.
Answer questions on this, and it says you tell us, and then we answer it, and we'll see what everybody thinks.
They're learning a different view from other students, too.
North Penn students and staff are not the only ones taking advantage of this technology. Some members of the North Penn community are taking their first steps into cyberspace by enrolling in North Penn's community education program.
With the implementation of our technology plan, we're now able to offer more courses to the community through our community education program.
The North Penn community education program offers classes on weeknights and Saturday mornings in computer applications, keyboarding, Excel, PowerPoint, Word 97, and web design.
There's always many people calling in asking for more courses. We're now able to offer them a variety of different classes, from designing your own web page to genealogy courses where you research your families on the internet, to PowerPoint, which we've never been able to offer before.
With all of North Penn's 18 buildings, including the Educational Service Center, now wired, Phase 3 of the technology plan is about to begin.
By the end of Phase 2, email and voicemail will be fully functional for teachers of the North Penn School District, and a satellite dish will be completely installed at the North Penn High School.
Well, throughout the training, I think the most exciting thing that's happening is seeing how teachers are making technology a part of their everyday learning as just as the textbook, the pencil, and the blackboard.
Phase 3 of the technology plan will continue the installation of computers for special subject areas, including art, music, health, physical education, and foreign language.
This is an exciting time to be part of the North Penn community.
17 schools with 1,200 computers and 250 classrooms, 4 new library labs, 15 computer labs, and 100 offices and planning centers have all been upgraded.
It's an exciting time because there's so many new tools, and the students are trying out all those new tools. They're finding out that it really helps them to learn, and the teachers enjoy it because it makes their job easier. Also, it helps them to get the students interested, and it provides them with different ways to present information.
In 3 years, the support of the community, the forward thinking and initiative of the North Penn Board of School Directors, the hard work and creativity of the North Penn staff, and the desire of each North Penn student to explore this wired world of education have brought the North Penn School District into the new millennium with a bang.
As we all know, technology is exploding in our society, and what we're finding are ways to incorporate technology into the classroom. And what's really exciting is to see how teachers and students take the basics of technology and apply it to everyday learning.
I think computers have been a great tool to engage students in the learning process. In my classroom, I'm currently using the computer in 3 important ways. I use it for the word processing, I use it for research, and I also use it for having the students make presentations related to book reports. Perhaps in the last week or so, we've done reports on countries around the world. So they've made presentations also using PowerPoint. HyperStudio could be used for these projects as well.
It's really exciting seeing the implementation of the technology plan here in the school district. In the past 2 years, so many really exciting new things have been introduced. It's fabulous to see that students and teachers embracing technology. They're learning and growing so much as we're moving into the future. It's been really wonderful.
I think it's an exciting time because there are so many more new tools in all of the classrooms and labs and libraries throughout the schools, and these are tools that the kids are used to. That's something that they already understand and know how to learn from.
Students in the North Penn School District continuously take advantage of the opportunities North Penn can offer, drawing from the extensive knowledge of the North Penn faculty.
North Penn students now have the best tools to access the world.